Amen. Amen. He is the exact image and likeness of God, not man. And when we failed to recognize what God has given to man, he said, I'm giving you dominion, right? Let man have dominion. God took himself out of the equation and he said, let them, meaning you and me, that we should have dominion, which in Greek they call mamlaka or basilia, which represents kingdom or rulership or authority. I mean, the word dominion is a bigger word. It has so many meanings, but one of the words I want to talk about dominion is kingdom. The word dominion means kingdom or rulership. So God gave dominion or a kingdom to man when he created him. What was the devil after when he came to Adam and Eve? Kingdom, right? It's a piece of land called earth that was given by God to his kids. Amen? God simply gave his children a piece of land called earth. That means he gave us kingdom to rule, to dominate, to have control, authority over this what? This piece of land. And what did we do with the piece of land? We handed it over to the devil on a silver platter. Right? We handed it over. That's why the Bible says he is the God of this world. Amen?
Amen.
The world and systems, amen, that operates within the world.
Amen.
Now Jesus is saying the kingdom, he has come, he has brought the kingdom that we handed over on chapter 3 of Genesis. Jesus is saying, it has come. It has arrived. So when he was talking, the people around him, they thought he was talking about a government around him, the systems around, okay? But he was saying the kingdom has come, and they could not, because they could not see what he was talking about, they didn't understand what he meant when he said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. It has come. What he was saying with the word repent, it means a total turn around. If you are going that direction, you have to go a different way. It's a total U-turn. Turn it from there and I'm going that direction. Amen? And now Jesus is bringing these messages to us as a church. And he continues to make these declarations over and over again. He dwells in his mission statement. He never went outside his mission statement. And I would like to bring some evidence from the mission statement of Jesus Christ, that his mission was about the kingdom of God. Nothing else but the kingdom. He had brought back to us what we lost in Genesis chapter 3. Even though he was in the process of handing over the kingdom to you, but he wanted us to have a transformational
Amen.
In our mind, the way of understanding. That's why he was saying, repent. He was saying, I want you to come from that other kingdom. You just understand this kingdom. Your mind is full of what this other kingdom is all about. I want you to have a repentance, a change of mind, a transformation of mind, and begin to understand about this kingdom that you lost. This is what I brought.
Hallelujah.
How do we know that Jesus' message and purpose and statement was continually about the kingdom? I want us to go to the book of Matthew. I'll talk more about the book of Matthew. Let's take our Bible to the book of Matthew and just hear what Jesus continued talking about. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says in Matthew chapter 10, verse 7, as you go, preach this message. What message? Are you on your Bibles? Are you reading your Bibles?
Okay.
I want to interact with you, okay?
Amen.
Let's go to Matthew 10, verse 7. I want to interact with you. Let's do it together.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is very important. I don't want you to go out quoting all Pastor St. Jesus as mission statement when this I want you to understand, if these were Jesus' words, if they are people who have Bibles with the red words, those are Jesus' words. Amen? Let's go to Matthew 10, verse 7. Let's look at some of these declarations which Christ made. Matthew 10, verse 7. He says to his disciples, as you go, he was commissioning, he was now training the disciples, or we call it internship, okay? Now we call that internship. He was putting his disciples on internship. They were to go out there and begin to exercise before him. He was a wonderful leader. He is the only leader I have seen who does not hold on to the baton stick. He knew how to pass on ministry, Pastor, more than the way we do it sometimes as pastors. But Jesus was this kind of man. That's why church is very important for you to listen to the vision, mission, and statement of the ministry, so that you understand the vision and run with it. It helps you when you are being discipled. Because when God decides to change things, you will not be lost from the vision. Amen? Jesus was imparting, teaching his disciples. He's saying, you are going to go out into the world. I'm sending you there into the world. But don't lose that mission statement. You understand? The declaration remains there. It says in Matthew 10, verse 7, as you go, preach this message. The kingdom of heaven is what? What was he talking about? The kingdom, right? What did he say? The kingdom of heaven is near. Amen? He's teaching them. Let's go again on Matthew chapter 12. Verse 28. We are just looking at the declaration of Christ concerning his mission on earth. Amen? Verse 28 says, but he's talking, he has had this discussion, and these people are accusing Jesus now. He's saying, you are a demon. How come you are casting out these spirits?